Good afternoon, my name's Craig Erlam, market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to today's daily market update. Today we've got stocks trading slightly high. We've got the European indices up by between 0.5 and 1%. It's been quite light trading this morning, but that doesn't come as too much of a surprise. We do have the jobs report to be released in the US this afternoon, and usually as we head towards this, we do tend to see a bit lighter trading. So like I say, not too much of a surprise there. Overnight we did have the meeting with the Bank of Japan. Now there was no change there. They did keep asset purchase at 80 trillion yen, no extension like we saw a couple of weeks ago, where we obviously saw the extension, the increase of 10 trillion yen. Interest rates also remain steady between 0 and 0.1%. Again, no real surprise here. So there's not been really too much of an impact on the markets as a result of that. Obviously, yesterday we did have some more news from the central banks. We had the Bank of England meet earlier in the day, and again, we didn't see too much change here. We saw interest rates remain at 0.5%. And the asset purchasing programme remain at £375 billion. It's next month's meeting, which we're going to be really keeping a close eye on. The current asset purchase actually expire in November, and we'll also have the some more data out the UK this month, in particular the GDP figure, which is expected to confirm the UK came out of recession this year, and these are all likely to contribute to whether we'll see further asset purchase next month, and if so, by how much. The ECB, again, there was no real change here. We did see interest rates remain at 0.75%. There was people looking for further information from Mario Draghi as to whether Spain were likely to request a bailout anytime soon, and if so, what conditions would be imposed on them. We didn't really get too much out of this, but what we did get was Mario Draghi standing by the euro once again, claiming that the euro is irreversible, and that this new OMTs are there as a backstop, and therefore do create some form of safety in the eurozone, which does reduce the chances essentially of countries requiring a full sovereign bailout again. So we did see a positive reaction to this. We did see a positive reaction to the fact that Mario Draghi did stand firm up against these questions, although we didn't actually get too many details out of the meeting in particular. Today, like I say, we are going to be looking ahead to the jobs report this afternoon. Unemployment is expected to jump up again. We did see it fall from 8.3% down to 8.1% last month. This is expected to move higher towards 8.2% again. Like I say, last month we did see it drop, but that wasn't so much to do with the fact that more people were finding work. As we've seen, the non-farm payroll figures have been poor over the last 6 months or so. So this wasn't really due to more people finding work. It was actually people stopping seeking work. So this actually contributed to the lower unemployment rate. We do expect to see this, though, as I say, pick up in September, or we expect to see that they did pick up in September, and we're expecting the unemployment figure to move up to 8.2%. As far as non-farm payrolls are concerned, we did again, like I say, see last month's figure fall back to 96,000. This was less than we were expecting, and yet another disappointing figure. This month we are expecting to see it move up slightly to 118,000, but this is still about half of what we're going to need if we're going to see this unemployment figure come down over the next 6 to 12 months. So it's still a very poor figure, but if we can see it slightly beat expectations, it might actually just boost investor confidence slightly as we enter the final quarter of the year. But like I say, the other thing we could see is if we do see another poor number, this could increase suggestions that we might actually see a further asset purchase from the Fed. If we look at the minutes from last month, we did see the Fed say that if conditions do continue to deteriorate, we will see further asset purchase. We do have Operation Twist ending at the end of the year, so that's $40 to $45 billion dollars of asset purchase that we won't see past the end of December. So if we do see these non-farm payroll figures continue to fall, this should indicate that we will see further asset purchase once we do see Operation Twist expire. So either way, we may actually see a positive reaction in the markets, whether it beats it or not. If we now take a look at the charts, we can see that the euro is trading around 130 against the dollar. It's trading just above here. We did see it make significant gains yesterday following the ECB press conference. It's now found resistance around this 61.8 fib line that you can see there on the charts, which is likely to cap it for the next few hours, at least until we get the non-farm payroll figures come out. If we do see it either beat expectations or even, like say, miss expectations, we could see the euro trade high, we could see risk appetite return to the markets, and we could see a target around 130, 171. Other than this, there's not too much happening. happening in this chart. So we'll just move on to the next one, which is the cable chart. Now this is trading around 162. You can see here, as we've been talking about over the last couple of days, it actually did break below this ascending triangle that's been trading for a number of months now. Now within 24 hours, we did see sterling make significant gains, actually pushing it back inside this ascending triangle, and now it looks like we may actually see it approach the top of this ascending triangle around 162.70, potentially forcing its way through, making a move substantially higher, maybe even reaching 165. For now though, as you can see there, it has actually found a resistance around the 61.8 fib line, and again this may cap the gains in the cable charts until we see these non-farm payroll figures this afternoon. Looking ahead to the US Open now, the S&P is expected to open flat. We've got the Nasdaq, which is expected to open 4 points higher, and we've also got the Dow, which is expected to open higher by around 13 points. Thank you very much for listening. My name's Craig Erlam, market analyst at Alpari UK.